It's good to be back out here. You know, I had a camp out here a long time ago, so we decided to bring it back out here. And it's a great turnout. You know, we had over 100 kids out here at Kennedy High School. We're ages 9 to 16.
What does it mean to you? Like you said, you had that gap a little bit.
Yeah.
Here you have a sold-out camp.
Well, it's great. You know, obviously, I think me coming back and connecting, you know, through the Kings and doing some media work with the Kings, obviously, you know, brought some excitement back around this camp. And it sold out in about 2 weeks. So, you know, we're just excited to still have a presence here and, you know, have turn out a quality camp.
You have camp kids of all ages. It's funny because some of them might remember you as a basketball player.
Right.
Like you said, maybe as a broadcaster,
media,
broadcaster. How much fun is that for them to know you in all these different ways?
It's great. You know, it means I'm somewhat relevant still, you know, to have a, you know, a 15-year career and then, you know, transition into media. It's been a blast. So whether they know me from talking on the TV or playing on the TV, I'm glad they're just out here supporting this week.
You've done this for a long time. What's the main thing you want someone to take away from when you're camp?
Well, I mean, I'm always trying to tell the mental approach. You know, don't shortcut the drill. You know, come out here to get better. Come out here to work on something. Listen to the coaches. And just play hard. I think a lot of times, sometimes we're in an era where kids want to be cool, and I'm not a big fan of that. I'm a fan of, you know, putting in the work and getting the results. So we just hope that, you know, they pick up some lessons and some discipline and focus.
Is a lot of some of these things similar to what you went through as a kid?
I never got a chance to go to any camps. You know, I was it was kind of a different time back then. So, you know, again, obviously being able to bring an experience out here for some of these kids. I know how important, you know, Sacramento loves their sports, so just to be able to come back here after all these years and put on a camp, I'm excited about.
I like looking out here and seeing two of your young kids.
Yeah, man, I got my sons here, and I got two, one of my nephews, and then one of my little cousins here as well, two of my little cousins here, so a lot of family affair out here this week.
You won't put any of these kids through anything, you won't put your own kids through.
All right, no, I'm gonna put my kids through work, so I just, like I said, my whole thing is getting kids better, whether it be physically or mentally, but just leave them with something.
We're seeing a lot of scrimmage. Is there a part of this camp that stands out as maybe one of the most fun that you've had?
The whole first half is skills. So from 9 to 12, we're doing skills in different stations and really coaching the kids up. And then after lunch, we break them up. We have the smaller kids in the smaller gym. And then we have middle school and high school in the bigger gym. And again, hoping kids just get something out of it.
And I know, you know, can't do it all yourself. You got a lot of people helping
you
out.
Oh, yeah.
How appreciative of you would you have some of the staff?
Oh, man. My cousin Christy and my guy Sam that I grew up out here playing basketball with, they really took the camp, you know, as their own and pretty much did everything. Allowed me just to come into Sacramento this morning, be a presence out here, do a little coaching, but they're really running everything, so I appreciate them.
Do you want to see maybe some of these kids year after year kind of become a
little absolutely. Familiar? Absolutely. You know, this is the first, it's going to be annual, you know, so we're going to do something here in Sacramento, something in the Bay, and then something in LA. So we want to continue to grow this. I told my boys this morning I want to pass this and give it to them next year. So it'll be the Twins camp next year, hoping to get all the top high school kids in each area to come out.
I love talking about Up in Smoke and what you're doing with that. That is now when it's like fourth season?
We literally just wrapped the season four. We just dropped the Iman Shumpert interview on Thursday, so we wrapped season four. So for the first time all year, I got about a 5-week break. So, you know, obviously camp is a part of it, but, you know, All the Smoke has been a blessing, you know, to have the caliber of guests we've had, to be able to have the success we've had. When we started, we didn't even know what a podcast was. So, you know, we're truly thankful for our guests, for our fans, for everybody behind the scenes that makes us successful.
How do you go from some of the peaks that you've had, be it Kevin Garnett, Kobe Bryant, even Jason Williams, who I saw you last week, to what lies ahead? Is there a bunch of people?
Just excitement, just more live. You know, obviously you want to continue to chase big names, but to me it's just better, more about the conversation. I know we're going to hopefully talk to the Kings and come out here and do something around training camp for All the Smoke around the Sacramento Kings. So just continuing to be creative and giving fans what they want.
And speaking of the Kings, how much have you enjoyed your time as a broadcaster?
Oh, man, it's been amazing, and especially the resurgence of the team. You know, I can't say enough about management, Monty McNair and Vivek and those guys, you know, hiring Mike Brown and really putting this roster together piece by piece. And this is a young, up-and-coming, exciting team, and I'm proud to be a part of it on the media side.
Did they exceed your own expectations this past year?
I did. They did. They definitely did. But when you think about it, it doesn't really surprise me because Mike Brown's pedigree and what he was able to learn on each stop, particularly that Warriors journey, he's been able to bring that experience. And the one thing I found out about that team is they really believe in Mike Brown. Every time you talk to the players, they're always crediting him. And that's just the fortitude to how much they trust and believe in him. So I'm excited not only for the team but for the city to see what this young team can do.
And lastly, just how much those expectations now exceed looking up to the next.
It's tough. You know what I mean? They're not going to be able to sneak up on anyone. They're not going to be the Cinderella story. Like, teams are going to be ready for the Kings, and I'm sure they're going to be ready for the rest of the league.
Appreciate you, sir.
Yeah, no doubt.